RW Peeps, it's your boy Glenn Lawrence, and I am back with another whispering review. And this time, I got the Hitman's Wife's Bodyguard for you. I didn't think I was going to like this movie this much, but I should have known the first one was pretty awesome, and this one did nothing but add more awesomeness to the package. We got more of Sonya Kincaid, which she was so great in the first one. It just makes this movie. It's like creme brulee when you got a heat gun. That means you cooked it right. It's actually probably a surprise hit for the summer for me. They're bringing back our characters that we loved from the first Hitman's Bodyguard. And I gotta say, they do a great job. Patrick Hughes directs this one. He is solid at directing. He had a vision for this. And I gotta tell you, it lives up to his vision. He wanted it to be outlandish and crazy, and it was. Now, this goes into a new genre and category of films that I like to call outlandish, crazy-ass motherfucking over-the-top action movies. Kind of like Fast and the Furious, but this one actually kind of makes sense. I really like the music choices in there. It keeps the story going, but I can't say enough about this cast. Salma Hayek really brings it this time. She's the cherry on top to everything that has happened. Ryan Reynolds is amazing again as Michael Bryce. You get all his little crazy synchronized, and I'm an idiot. Listen, movie was great. Samuel Jackson, he's incredible. He's impeccable in this movie once again. And I have to say, the thing about this movie is, it's like an assassin's bullet. It has to hit a precise target at a precise time, and it does that. I don't think any other cast could have made this movie as dope as it was. Like, they just fit together so well. We're having so much fun throughout the entire movie. Now, the movie brings us back to Michael Bryce. He is a bodyguard. He's actually having a little bit of a breakdown from the last time we met and we had our crazy adventure. And he's trying to get himself back together. That is quickly interrupted when he runs into an old friend's wife who takes him on this crazy adventure. All kind of hijinks ensued. Michael Bryce is taken through the ringer. He's beat up, punched, shot, hit by a bunch of cars, all this type of stuff. I'm not going to spoil the end for you, but let's just say it's wild. And he continues to get all sorts of punishment. You're going to love it. If you like outlandish comedy, you're going to love this movie. I liked it a ton. I like that they gave the character some depth. The crazy thing is, with all the craziness that's going on with this movie, the depth that they have to the characters is great. Like Michael Bryce, I don't want to ruin the joke for you, but let's just say he is very particular and he loves his seatbelt. If you cast any other people with this script, I feel like it could have went way off the rails, but it's the perfect mix. And they add in Morgan Freeman, and he is just, once again, the right pitch for this movie. Like, it's perfect. It all fits together so well, and you really, 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 really can enjoy this movie. It's just summer popcorn fun. You're really going to like it. My favorite part, like, they had the sea jets, you know, the little hose where they like spray the water thing. Those people come out. So they got henchmen on sea jets. Okay. And it's just as stupid as you think. The pen is mightier than the sword. I love that phrase, and they show it here. So that's another plus for this movie. I gotta say, there are so many different parts of this movie that I really enjoyed. The jokes are funny. You know how sometimes they have like an action movie and then the jokes are kind of like, eh? I laughed out loud at least 17 times in this movie because it was just so funny. Now, the supporting cast in this movie is, I don't know, it doesn't matter, because the whole time you're just watching Ryan Reynolds and Samuel Jackson and Selma Hayek go at it, and they all hold their own impeccably. I love it. Selma Hayek is the new crazy. I saw her in Bliss with Owen Wilson. She plays crazy in that one too. She's amazing. She took a hiatus or something from acting for a while because I hadn't seen her in a bunch of movies, but now I'm seeing her in more movies. She's going to be in The Eternals coming up, and I can't wait because she's just so good. I forgot how good she is. I loved her all the way back since Fools Rush In. That was good. She made Matthew Perry look good. Okay, if you like Friends, you might think Matthew Perry looked great in it or does great in it, But look, she carried that movie, and she carries this movie as well, which is crazy because Ryan Reynolds carries the movie too. It's like they're all carrying. It's like when you have movers, and the movers are all good, and it's just a concert. They get the couch up the stairs. That's what happens in this film. I mean, they don't actually in the film have a couch that goes up the stairs, but what they do have are a lot of bullets. There's a lot of bullets flying. That's the other thing about it. It's crazy action. The stunt team in this film, but they do a great job. Everything felt just very impactful. The explosions were great. And the scenes and the set pieces and the things that they're doing are amazing. The fights are incredible. And you're really just having fun the entire movie. If it's not action happening, it's comedy. If it's not comedy happening, it's action. And if it's none of those things happen, it's hilarity. Wait, that's the same thing as comedy. But there's also a little drama in there. You get a little heartfelt moment with some of the characters too. And you feel those too. That's what's so weird about it. It's outlandish, but it still has heart and it's still really funny and the action is still great. Look, I'm buzzing over this. And I don't usually buzz over movies at this hour. You know what I'm saying? Because I could get in trouble for that type of thing. But this movie has me going wild. I really liked it. I would probably watch 10 of these movies. As a matter of fact, no, I'd watch 11 of these movies plus a space finale and a Christmas special. That's how good this movie is. I can't wait to see the next one, which may be the hitman's wife's bodyguard's cousin or son or daughter or maybe in-laws. That might be a good angle to do. This one could go on forever. I'd watch the entire family tree. The Kincaids are unkillable, and I love that. That means we're going to get a lot of these. The casting was perfect. The acting was perfect. Everything was pretty much spot on. You can't beat it. For your summer viewing entertainment dollars, you can't go wrong. Go see this movie. So there you have it. I love the movie. It's great. Now, if I was ranking this movie, I would have to give it...
Can you keep it down out here?
Yeah, sorry. My rating system goes a little bit like this, from lowest to highest. It's a shrug, a whisper, two whispers, or a can you keep it down? But if a movie's really good, it gets a hell no, I ain't keeping it down. This movie gets a hell no, I ain't keeping it down. Yeah, it gets a hell no, I ain't keeping it down. So this has been Glenn Lawrence in another whispering review for The Hitman's Wife's Bodyguard. Go see it and keep it down.